This week, the New Zealand National Emergency Management Agency is running a simulation of a major earthquake. The agency is running this simulation at a magnitude 8 quake, which is likely to hit the country sometime in the next 50 years. Our correspondent Jack Nyhoff was given a rare glimpse inside.
A few floors under New Zealand's Beehive is the bunker. Officially known as the National Crisis Management Centre, it's always ready for disaster.
I'd rather practice during peacetime.
This week, around 150 staff from agencies across the country descended on the stairs for a mock magnitude 8 earthquake.
Day one is about activating the National Crisis Management Centre. Day two is putting the events, if you like, or the situation 2 weeks down the track.
The simulation is a chance to test the system because the real event could happen at any time.
The Alpine fault, I think, is because it potentially could sever up the whole fault line itself, which would mean that it would take out major infrastructure.
Scientists say there's a 75% chance of an Alpine fault earthquake that's greater than magnitude 7 hitting in the next 50 years.
The fault line could also and will cause substantial casualties and injured persons. It will overwhelm the system, so the system may not be able to cope. We've got to test that.
Participants from 32 agencies started their morning with an early automated call.
The ideal would be within an hour or two. So today, for example, the earthquake was programmed to have occurred at 6 o'clock. We had this up and running by 8 o'clock this morning.
The fake scenario, kept secret from the news media, played out in real time throughout the day.
It's the potential tsunami threat, and that is a real concern for us. You know, the uplift of our seas to create a tsunami is where we will see more fatalities. It's about seeing where the gaps are, where we need to improve.
The clever simulation also offering us a rare glimpse inside the depths of New Zealand Parliament. Jack Nyhoff, Sky News, Wellington.